Hello everyone, today I will show you the game called Banished. I suggest you start the game with a tutorial, which is very straightforward and useful in both how it presented itself and how it helped me. Banished clearly indicated that it wanted me to access and comprehend its systems, but then my first harsh winter happened where half of my town died to starvation. First Banished teaches its system, then it crushes you with them. Well, as you can see, the game uses a clean and minimalist and customizable interface. Nearly all of the what appears on the screen is the city itself, but you should open some information windows like general statistics and events and the job assignation panel. And once you build the town hall, this is provides very useful information as well. Its difficulty doesn't come from struggling to figure out what's happening or how to understand it, how to understand the game. It's coming from the speed of your expansion. Your city is always on the verge of collapse. It does this in few ways. Population wise, unlike most city builder game, immigration is not the chief method of the expansion. You can only grow by having children, which occurs when you build new houses. So young families could move to these new homes. But But kids are useless. They eat, so they consume food, but they don't work. Too many kids lead to the little food, and so it leads to famine. If you build too few houses, your population ages and shrinks. It's a constant balancing act. Banished also uses physical space to effect. If the distance between home and workplace is too great, then citizens become inefficient workers. Okay, let's see the features of the game, the available resources, and some information about how to set up your buildings properly. First of all, you need storage barns and stockpiles. In stockpiles you can reserve resources, natural resources. In storage barns there are crafted or hunted resources. The first source of food will be definitely from fishers, from hunters, and from gatherers. These last two will only work effectively if they are in a forest, so it is recommended to build a forester lodge, which will be your source of logs. Logs are used as building materials and as a fuel to heat up houses. To create firewood, you need woodcutters. Your citizens need tools, so the presence of a blacksmith is required. A blacksmith produces iron or steel tools. which require logs, iron and coal. Irons and stones are gathered by your laborers. From rocks, but this will be gone fast, so you will need to build some quarries and mines. The main problem with these buildings is that they will be depleted sooner or later and leaving useless terrain behind. Coal is only available from the mines. Another important need your citizens are the clothes, which is produced by tailors. As you can see, there are three different coats, one produced by leather, one by wool, and the third produced by leather and wool. Leather delivered by your hunters. As you can see, they produce leather and food, and they also delivered by your herdsmen. Food included, and the wool delivered also by your herdsmen if they working with sheep. And the pastures also creates food. The third animals which could be used for pastures are chickens. Each of your citizens has a happiness and health rating. Happiness is easy to satisfy just by having wells and chapels. Keeping up a decent health rating is more challenging. You will need to have herbalists, so they can collect herbs and create medicines from those herbs. While the doctors, well, if I find a hospital, I can't find any right now. Oh, here is one. So the doctors at hospitals cure illnesses. Once your city is balanced, you can start trading and grow your population. You can trade through your trading post. Merchants will eventually visit your trading posts. There are many different merchants, some selling few foods, some selling raw materials and or crafted items or seeds. As money not existing in the game, you trade for these items with other resources. You can store these resources at your trading post, so it acts as a storage barn. These stocked resources not available for the use of your population. This merchant selling seeds. At the beginning of the game, you don't own any seeds, which is required for orchards and farms, so you need to purchase these. You need to purchase only each seed only once. After that, you can build as many farm or orchards with the same seed type. So you're playing with your restocked items. Yeah, I could purchase this, but I don't need this one. You can also order items. Next time the merchant visit your trading port, he will deliver the required items for an increased price. So once you own a seed, you can create farms or orchards for additional feud income. Those were farms, and here's one orchard. Last important feature of the game is education. You can build schoolhouses. Your citizens become adult at age 10, so they can be assigned to a workplace after age 10, unless you have some schoolhouses, then they become students until age 18. So you can ask, why is it good for being educated? Well, it's obvious, uneducated citizens working slower, producing less and dying to stupid events. So you can call this effect as evolution. Well, the town hall provides additional information like statistics, graphs. This helps you to check your feud balance. It will tell you if you can expand or grow your city. Well, you should always check the statistic for multiple years, because the first one shows the statistics for current year, which isn't always optimal for feud production, because the harvest for orchards and farms are at autumn, so these numbers might be very unbalanced until late autumn. Okay, I think I told you all features of the game. This is a bit hard game to balance. It's very challenging, but it is a very good one. It is a highly recommended game. Well, I have currently nearly 800 population. The last achievement for population asking for 900, so here is one trick about how can you earn that a bit faster. There are so-called nomads in the game. Sometimes they asking for citizenship. If you allow them, then they become your citizens. They are uneducated, so they aren't optional citizens, and accepting that many will definitely ruin your empire. But I need know only this last achievement, so let's accept them. And I earned the last achievement. My city turned into a town. So I hope you will enjoy this game if you ever decide to play it. Please don't forget to subscribe and like the video.